Hi, my name is Melissa van Dijk, and in this video we're going to look into if you can use your salicylic acid and BHA together. And I often see this question in my comments where you think that those are also two separate products and therefore you can also use them in the same routine. But once you understand that in the cosmetic industry, BHA, which stands for beta hydroxy acid, is the same as salicylic acid, then it also will make a lot more sense that you only need to use one of them and you don't need to have an extra BHA solution just because it mentions BHA on it and an extra salicylic acid solution just because it mentions salicylic acid on it. Both also exfoliate your skin because it is the same. And so what salicylic acid can do for your skin is also deeply unclog your pores, exfoliate the way that that skin cells on your skin surface, and depending on the percentage, it also can be an acne treatment which you can also get over the counter. And if you're going to use too much of salicylic acid or BHA, then it also can lead to irritation. So therefore, it is also important that you find the right formulation of skincare product that also works the best for you, because you can get salicylic acid BHA cleansers, also solutions which you're going to leave on the skin or mask, as well as also creams. And so therefore it is important to understand that it is the same. And so if you have, for example, a salicylic acid cleanser or BHA cleanser at home, you have already a cleanser that can exfoliate your skin and unclog your pores. You don't need to use an extra salicylic acid BHA solution afterwards, because if you're using too much of it, it can lead to dryness, it can lead to over exfoliation, stinging, as well as also sensitivity. So to also reduce the likelihood of experiencing it, stick to one of them. And so I have a few examples in front of me, which I want to share with you so that you understand that there is no difference, that it is the same, but just the formulation can change. So I have two examples right here. I have the Inkislist Salicylic Acid Cleanser, which also mentions salicylic acid right on front. It also includes 2% of it, which it also mentions on the back of the packaging. And then on the other hand, I also have Paula's Choice 2% BHA Liquid Exfoliant, and right underneath it mentions salicylic acid. So you can see right here, which is a great example, that the 2% BHA is the 2% of salicylic acid. So if you also would use, for example, two products that includes both 2% of salicylic acid in the same routine, like you cleanse your face with a salicylic acid cleanser, plus you're going to use a leave-on solution, this can be too much for the skin. And so therefore, I recommend only choosing one of them. And so this is also where you can see that even though it mentions a different word on the packaging, that it also is the same. Another example also would be La Roche-Posay Effaclar Micro Peeling Cleanser. It does not really mention right here on the top part that it is a salicylic acid cleanser, but right here underneath it mentions that it also includes 2% of salicylic acid. So again, we have a strength of 2% of salicylic acid. Then I also have another example, which is also a leave-on exfoliating serum. And this is also by Face Theory, where it says a BHA exfoliating serum, but it includes 2% of salicylic acid in it. So again, I do not recommend using, for example, those two together. And then I also have another example for you, and this is also if you also would use, for example, the CeraVe SA cleanser. The SA stands for salicylic acid. Now with the CeraVe SA cleanser, because it does not mention a percentage of how much salicylic acid it includes anywhere, nor on the packaging, nor also on their website, it's basically a guessing game. It can be a low percentage, because that's why they haven't written it on it, but you never know. And so therefore, I often see the question, can I use my CeraVe as a cleanser with, for example, the ordinary peeling solution or the ordinary salicylic acid mask? Please don't do this. This can lead to over-exfoliation, depending also on your skin tolerance. So to have the best experience possible, when also using a salicylic acid mask, which also includes salicylic acid in it, stick to a gentle cleanser, like, for example, CeraVe Gentle Skin Cleanser, Oily Cleanser, Foaming Cleanser. They have different ones for different skin types. So with the ordinary peeling solution, I do get it why it can be confusing, but it's also a great example. It mentions 30% of AHA, which are different exfoliating acids, and 2% of BHA. Again, the 2% of BHA are standing for 2% of salicylic acid. So if you would use them together, again, you would maybe over-exfoliate your skin. And the same also would be if you would use a mask and then a leave-on exfoliating solution afterwards. So please, if you have a salicylic acid mask, do not use, for example, Paula's Choice BHA afterwards, or do not use the ordinary salicylic acid solution afterwards, because both products already contain salicylic acid. So therefore, you have to be cautious about it. If you have maybe a few products where it also mentions BHA or salicylic acid on it, let's say you have a cleanser and a leave-on exfoliating acid at home, both include BHA, salicylic acid, then choose the one that works the best for you. If you prefer a cleanser because you can rinse it off, that's totally fine. Keep on going with a very gentle, like, skincare routine. If you also want to use a leave-on exfoliant, stick to a gentle cleanser, and that's basically already enough. If you only want to use a mask once or twice per week, that's fine too. Keep the rest of the routine simple. If you have a cream that also includes salicylic acid in it, only use the cream. Stick to a gentle cleanser. Please do not use a leave-on exfoliating acid with salicylic acid in it. So that you also have a better understanding that once you have one product at home that targets your concern, do not overdo it, because it can lead to irritation. And this is also what I mainly want to teach you with this specific video, that BHA and salicylic acid in the cosmetic industry are the same. So only stick to one of them, see how it goes. If you feel the need, you also want to try something else, then stop using the other one. Let's say you also are currently using a salicylic acid cleanser, but you also want to try a leave-on exfoliating acid. That's fine, you can switch it. But just make sure that you're not going to keep on going with a salicylic acid cleanser, but replace it with a gentle cleanser and then use your leave-on exfoliating acid. So that you have an idea of how you can balance it to get most out of it, so that it also targets your concern, but also minimize the risk of getting an irritation. And this is also what I wanted to teach you and share with you in this specific video. Please always read on the packaging. Does it mention about a percentage? Does it mention salicylic acid or BHA on the packaging? Then you know it's the same thing, and you also know with what you're dealing with. I do hope that you enjoyed this video and that you also find it helpful. If you did so, please also don't forget to give the thumbs up as well as share it. And thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon in the next one. Happy skincaring. Bye.